Hello friends, welcome to the video tutorial of ASP.NET MVC code snippet. And in this video, we are going to study how to implement option group or OPT group in drop-down list. Here, we are going to take a help of drop-down list helper in MVC. So as you can see here in this picture, see this clothing and footwear are the groups. Whereas the jeans, trousers, shirts, sports shoes, flats, heels, all these are what? Options. Before this, I already told you how to use drop-down list, but at that time we only displayed the option. But here we are going to study how to create this OPT group. Okay, so let us see this part practically. So as you can see here, I already created one web application in MVC, that is drop-down OPT group, as well as I added one home controller. Okay, one index method is already there, and I created a view for this, and as well as I created one model, and that model name is product. Now whenever you want to create or whenever you want to implement option group in your drop down, at least you need three fields. Okay, so this ID is going to be a value that is posted to the server. Then product name is nothing but the options that you want to show, whereas the category is nothing but your option group. So category is what? It is your OPT group, and product name is nothing but your options. Okay, basically you can say this is your option text, whereas product ID is nothing but option value. Okay, so here I'm going to show you this part using static data. But once you got this, definitely you can fetch a data from the database and you can populate a drop-down list and you can display it in the form of option group. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to write one method in this model only. Okay, basically this method will appear in your data access layer whenever you are interacting with your database. So let us create one method. So I'm going to create one static method here, public static IEnumerable. It will return list of product. Let us call it as get products. Okay, now here I'll create one collection of list. So list of product, LST product is equal to new list of product. Here I'm going to create here I'm going to use list initializer. Okay, so let us create one product. So new product, so product ID is equal to 1, then product name is equal to say jeans, and category is equal to clothing. Okay, now in the same way, what will I do? I'll add few more product and I'll enter some category also. So as you can see here, I added 5 more products. Okay, and first 3 belongs to clothing category, whereas last 3 belongs to footwear category. Okay, now whenever you are fetching this data from the database, definitely your category will be a separate table and product will be a separate table. In that case, you will do a join, and definitely at the end you will put your data in the view model. Okay, so at least it should have a 3 fields, remember this thing. Now let us say return LST product. Okay, now we're done with our model. What is the next step? Let us write a code on controller. So here I already imported the namespace of our models. Okay, generally we populate our drop down using viewback. So what will I do? First of all, I'll collect the we will give call to this get product method, and we will collect all the products in our IEnumerable collection. Okay, so IEnumerable product, say LST prod is equal to product dot get product. Now since it is static method, I'm calling it by a class name. Now next step, see here you will get your product. So next step is to pass your data to a view using viewback. So viewback dot, so here you have to specify any key. Let us call it as product list is equal to LST prod. Now what is the next step? Next step is to create a view. So let us switch to view. Say go to view. Look at here. So I just added this heading, implementing HTML OPT group in drop-down list. Now let us add one div tag, and here I'm going to apply bootstrap class, that is form-group. Okay. Now let us add one label to display the caption, say select product. Just a plain label will appear before your drop-down list. Now here I'm going to use HTML helper, basically standard HTML helper. So html.dropdownList, then you have to specify the name of your drop-down list, say let us say product ID. Since I'm going to post a product ID, basically it can be any name. Then we are going to create an instance of select list. Okay, now to this select list we have to provide the required argument, and just have a look the overload that we are going to use. Okay, so we are going to use the seventh overload of select list constructor. So first of all, I have to specify the enumerable items which are in my view bag. Okay, so let us copy this part, paste it. Okay, now what is the second argument? Second argument is the value field. So my value field is what? Product ID. Okay, then what is my text field? Text field is product name. Okay, and next is group field. Group field is what? I want to group it by category. Okay, so here I am using the same name that we created in our model. So product ID is my value field, product name is text field, whereas category is our option group. Now it has one more argument to pass. Okay, so here you have to specify the selected value, which value you want to select by default. So I do not want to select any particular item, so I'll say 0. Okay, so at that time my option label gets selected. Now next argument is you have to give the option label, say select product. Okay, means since I set it to 0, my select product option gets selected always. If I set it to 1, then my first option gets selected. Okay, now the last argument is CSS class. So let us apply it using anonymous class. So we already studied this part while studying the standard helper. So if you are not familiar with that part, please watch the video upside. Now I want to apply form dash control class to my drop down list. Okay, now in the same way you can create a drop down list for helper, means strongly type helper also. Just your first argument get changed. Here you have to specify what? Lambda expression. That is the only thing that we have to change. Now let us execute it and we will check the output. Now look at here, it get loaded in our browser. See, the clothing and footwear both are what? Categories. Definitely you cannot select this, you can select these options only, even you cannot click over here. Okay, so I hope you understand this, and definitely you can do it yourself using entity framework also. Just try it with entity framework, fetch your data from a database using entity framework and populate your drop down list along with a category. So if you have any doubt, definitely you can share it with me. Thank you.